Welcome back, friends. Friends, we have launched our website achieversenglish.com to provide you focused learning. This site is designed to provide you all the English learning videos in a sequence so that your learning becomes easy and enjoyable. So please visit our website and share it with your friends too. Friends, we have completed the first part of speech noun, and today we are beginning with the second part of speech, that is pronoun. Pronouns also helped in picking out adjectives. So I would advise my all the viewers to go through all the kinds equally, because it's going to link with other parts of speech. Let's get started.
Now we will see what are pronouns and where they are used. Look at the sentences. My mother is in the kitchen. My mother is busy preparing a dish. The dish will be tasty. In the first sentence, we have introduced my mother. Mother is a noun. In the second sentence, we are repeating my mother again. In the second sentence, we have introduced a dish, but in the third one, we are repeating the dish again. In place of my mother, if we write she, and in place of the dish, if we write it, then we are removing unnecessary repetition of some nouns. So now if we read the sentence, my mother is in the kitchen. She is busy preparing a dish. It will be tasty. This sentence is not looking awkward now. Let's see the next one. The rich are not always happy. Look at the rich. The rich have their own worries. We have introduced the rich in the first sentence. So there is no need to repeat the rich in the second and third sentence. In place of them, we can write, the rich are not always happy. Look at them. And in the third one, we can write, they have their own worries. So, a word used in the place of noun is called pronoun. The word pro means for. It means that pronouns are used for nouns. So, they do the same function as of noun. Pronouns are of different kinds. They are personal, possessive, interrogative, demonstrative, distributive, reflexive, emphatic, indefinite, and relative. Let's begin with the first kind. Before that, we should see what are the grammatical person chart. Friends, this chart will not only help you in understanding pronoun, but I must say that this will help you in picking out all the parts of speech. So let's start and let's see what are the grammatical person chart. In English grammar, the person are divided into three categories, first, second, and third. The first person is I. The second person is you. If you remove I and you out of anything, everything or every person is third. If it is one person or thing, it is in singular, third person singular. If they are many, then it becomes third person plural. For example, one pen is kept in front of you, so the pen will be third person singular. And if there are more pens kept on the table, then it will be third person plural. So it's clear that if we talk about first person plural, then it will be we, because we includes I also. When I is first person singular, then we will be first person plural. If you is second person singular, then you all will be second person plural. Now let's go ahead. Personal pronoun. The name itself suggests that it is replacing person. So these pronouns replace names of persons or things. We can take the help of this personal pronoun chart. Now let's see. He went to the market. It is important to them. Which sweater do you want? She went with him. They won the league. I am going to return her pen. If we look at these sentences, the highlighted words are personal pronoun. But now we will see that how they are personal pronoun. Because at the places where pronouns are written, we can easily write any person's name or thing's name. Like he went to market. In place of he, Raj could have written. So Raj went to market. But when you want to replace Raj, then you will write he went to market. So Raj is a noun which is replaced. Now she went with him. Like she went with father. So father is replaced by him. They won the league. So at the place of they also, any people's name can come. So it means that these pronouns replace person's name or thing's name. So they are called personal pronoun. These pronouns shows possession or ownership. The words which we use in possessive pronouns are hers, his, mine, theirs, yours, and ours. Like, this bicycle is hers. If this bicycle is Sheena's, so Sheena could be replaced and it could be written hers. You can use mine if you want. In place of writing the name, we can write mine. This car is his. His is replaced for some person who belongs to that car. So in this way, we can see that all the words are possessive pronouns because they are showing ownership. Those flowers are of my neighbors. So my neighbors could be replaced. And we have written that those flowers are theirs. Let's see the next one. Interrogative pronoun. Friends, if you have gone through kinds of sentences video, then you will remember that interrogative sentences are those which ask a question. So these pronouns ask a question, and the words we use here are who, whom, whose, which, and what. The examples are, who are you talking to? Which of these car is yours? What is the meaning of life? Whose is this book? Whom do you want to see? Who is knocking at the door? So these interrogative pronouns have come in place of some nouns. Like, who is knocking at the door? The peon is knocking at the door. Peon is a noun and it could be replaced by who. So in this way, the interrogative pronouns are formed. But a very important thing to remember, that if I use these words in this way, where they are followed by noun, like house is a noun, book is a noun, or plan is a noun, then these words which, whose, and what will become interrogative adjective. So please remember that those words which modify noun are adjectives. Another way to find out adjectives are that adjectives and noun stand together. Adjective of quality comes anywhere, but all the other adjectives comes always before noun. So in this way, these words have become adjectives. Friends, with interrogative pronoun, we have to remember one more thing, that the words written here, who, whom, whose, which, and that, are only interrogative pronouns. But if you make a question with where or why or when, then it will become interrogative adverbs. The reason is that if you ask any question that where is my dog? So what will be the answer? That the dog is in the park or the dog is outside? So is where replacing any noun? No. If you ask a question, why are you late? That I was late because the bus came late. So again, you are not able to replace the answer with noun. But if you ask, which of these cars is yours? Like, you are pointing towards two cars, one is blue and one is red. So you are asking that which of these car is yours. So answer will come that this car is mine. So at this place, you are replacing noun. Therefore, this word is interrogative pronoun. But if you are unable to replace noun, then those words become interrogative adjectives. I'll talk about it later in the concerned video. So please make sure that along with this video, you watch that too. Now see the next one. Demonstrative pronoun. These pronouns indicate noun in a sentence. The meaning of indicate is to point out. The word this, that, those, and these are used to indicate something. Like, what are these? Suppose some mangoes are kept on the table and we have to point out and ask about mangoes. So we will ask, what are these? These means mangoes. I have never seen those before. We are talking about some houses. If you are pointing out towards some houses, you can ask, I have never seen those. So it means that the word those is pointing towards houses. So it is clear that these words are used to demonstrate something or to indicate something. I am not going to eat this. Those are your clothes. This is what I said. These are merely excuses. So these words are replacing nouns. But again, we have to take care. If such words are coming before noun, then these words become demonstrative adjective. So we have to remember that if there is a noun after these words, then it will be adjective. If there is not, then it will be demonstrative pronoun. Next one is distributive pronoun. These pronouns refer to persons or things one at a time. Like these words, each, either, and neither are used to refer person individually. Like, Each of Mr. Thakur's son got a share. Now suppose Mr. Thakur has three sons and we are using each for them. So we are saying that each of Mr. Thakur's son got a share. It means that we are not talking about them collectively. We are talking about each of them at a time. In the same way, either of the applicants can be appointed. If there are three applicants, so we are talking about each applicant individually. Either of the applicant can be appointed. So we can learn this pronoun by associating with the word distributive, that they are distributed individually. So in the same way, we can see other examples. Neither of them is qualified. Each was asked the same question, means if there are five people sitting, so each was asked the same question. So question was asked from each one of them. Either of these roads leads to the station. Neither of the accusation is true. So it is clear that it is referring to person one at a time. Let's see the next one. Friends, now comes reflexive pronoun. But along with the reflexive pronoun, I want to draw your attention towards the emphatic pronoun also. It's noticeable that the words used in reflexive pronouns are same as with emphatic pronouns. But there is little difference between the two. If we go through the examples, we'll come to know that in this pronoun, the action which is done by the subject is turning back upon the subject. Like, I saw myself reflected in her eyes, or Arya accidentally cut herself, then this word, which is a pronoun, is reflecting upon the subject. In the next sentence too, the building fell itself, the word pronoun is reflecting upon the subject. But if we read emphatic pronouns, we will find out that the same pronouns are giving full emphasis on the subject. It is emphasizing subject with the pressure that I myself saw him coming, or she herself told me so. So reading out these sentences will make us know that the full emphasis is on the subject. Emphatic is made out of emphasis, and the full emphasis is on the subject. In both the sentences, pronouns are same, but the place of usage will be different. Here the pronouns are used after the verb saw, cut, fell, went, and made. These are verbs, and after the verbs they are used, but in emphatic pronoun, just after the subject they are used. It means that they want to give full pressure on the subject. In this sentence, subject will be you. So my dear friends, if you have gone through the kinds of sentences, you will remember imperative sentences, and in imperative sentences the subject is always you. So when you want to understand one concept, it's very important that you go through other grammatic topics too. Therefore, I appeal in the beginning of every topic that please watch all the videos, because they link with each other. In the next sentence, the building itself fell. The pressure is on building. But if you come back to the same sentence in reflexive pronoun, the building fell itself. So fell and itself are interchanged. So in this way, we can see that there is very small difference between the two, although the words in both are same. Friends, next come indefinite pronoun. The word itself suggests that which is not definite, not specific. They refer to persons or things in a general way. They are not specifying anything. They are not talking about particular things. Examples are anybody, everybody, some, both, several, none, anything, nothing, etc. Like, some are born great. Till now, this would be clear that the pronouns are those words which are replacing noun. If a noun has come at this place, we can replace it with pronouns. So in the indefinite pronouns, the pronouns which are replaced are indefinite. So like, if you are saying some are born great, so we don't know how many people are born great. There are some in number. Many were invited, but few came. Again, no specific number. Only we have talked in general. All are not wise. All means in a general way we are saying all. No specific number of people. And in the same way, none, somebody, and others are another examples of indefinite pronoun. Let's see the next one. Relative pronoun. Relative suggests relates. Relates means to join. These pronouns join a phrase or clause with another in a sentence. So dear friends, you know that phrase is a group of words which is incomplete, and clause is a complete sentence. The words we use here are who, whom, whose, which, that, but remember that these are the same words which we used in interrogative pronouns too. But the difference is that interrogative pronoun is asking a question, like which is my book? But if I say that the book which I gave him is lost, so I'm talking about the book which I gave him. I'm joining this phrase to a clause. So this pronoun joins a phrase or a clause. Again, all that she spoke was relevant. All is a phrase and she spoke was relevant is a clause, complete sentence. So I am joining these two by using that. In the same way, the pen, I am joining the pen with the rest of the part. The pen whose nib is broken can't be used. So I am joining these two groups by writing whose. The man who is wearing a hat is my dad. I am talking about the man who is wearing a hat. So I am joining these two. The lady whom you met is my aunt. I am again joining this phrase with a clause. So in this way, we have come to know that interrogative pronouns are used to ask a question like who is that man or whom were you talking to. But if the same words I am using to join a phrase or a clause, it becomes relative pronoun. So friends, here I am ending with pronouns. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe our channel and also hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Visit our website achieversenglish.com to get all the contents at a place. You can also email us at achieversenglishcoaching@gmail.com.